Hello, welcome to Ludic Science. In this video I will talk about these little modules, DC to DC voltage converter. And they are versatile modules and very cheap. You put a DC voltage at the input, for example 12 volts, and at the output you can have any voltage in between, from a minimum of 4.5 volts up to 12 volts that you have at the input. The maximum input voltage is 36 volts. And you can convert the voltage supposedly at high efficiency, because it is very easy to make your own circuit to have variable voltage, for example, using an LM317 transistor. But that kind of circuit is very inefficient. For example, if you convert from 24 to 12 volts DC, half of the input power will be lost as heat. And on the other hand, these modules promise an efficiency of at least 95%. But I will check that in a minute. And they are very cheap. You can buy this module in AliExpress for a couple dollars, but locally I bought this module for $6, which is still very cheap. Next time you need a PCB for your electronics project, consider using the professional services of JLC PCB. JLC PCB is the world leader in PCB fabrication. You can order online. You just need to register, upload your Gerber file, and wait a few days for your PCBs at an unbeatable price. As an example, you can connect a 9-volt battery to the input of the module. And there it is. I think this is the voltage of the battery. It's the maximum that you can have at the output, of course. But you can go and move the potentiometer to reduce the voltage to the level that you need for your application. For example, I can set it to 5 volts in order to use it as a cell phone charger. Okay, so let's check the efficiency of the module, which can be obtained by the output power divided by the input power. Remember that power is voltage times current. So I have here the module. It is connected to my power supply. So we know the input voltage from the power supply and the input current also. For example, 15 volts and 426 milliamps at the input. The product of these two values is the input power. And at the output, I have connected this power resistor as a load, and the output voltage is that given by the module, and I am measuring the current with the multimeter. Let's check first using an input voltage of 15 volts and an output voltage of 10 volts. Here we can see the input current and the output current in the multimeter. So let's write down these values and calculate the efficiency. Here are the results. Voltage and current at the input, the product gives a little bit above 8 watts, and voltage and current at the output, so the output power is 7.1 watts. The division of 7.1 divided by 806 gives an efficiency of 88%. Okay, let's repeat the calculation, but now using a larger differential voltage. I am setting 20 volts at the input at 10 at the output. And again, I will take note of the voltage and current values. Okay, now with a larger reduction in voltage, we can see that the efficiency is slightly lower, from 88 to 86%. Finally, I will use 30 volts at the input, and let's calculate the efficiency again. So, as it was expected, the efficiency is even lower, 82%. So, we can see that with small voltage differences, from 15 to 10 volts, the efficiency is higher, 88%. Not bad, but it is not close to the claimed value by the manufacturer that says that the efficiency is at least 95%. So there it is, a dirt cheap voltage converter with not too bad efficiency. You can buy these modules on different values of power. This is 250 watts, 8 amps maximum, but you can get them at values of current of 15-20 amps also. Thanks for visiting my channel. Hope you liked the video and see you in the next one.